I'm Andrea with Board Riders Review. We're here at the Sacred Craft Show. We're here with Sean Mattison with Von Sol. Sean, tell us, you have several different really awesome designs here. Tell us a little bit about some of these designs that you have.
All right, the first board I'm going to talk about is a board that I actually shaped and designed. I call it the Shadow. And where I'm going with these boards, which we would call alternative boards, but they're very high performance mixed with elements of traditional boards, is that this particular model is, say, a hybrid between something you would find in a fish, but modifying the bottom contours and the outline and the tail to put the board of that sort of a category in maneuverability in places that most fishes can't go just because of their outline. If I show you this board right here, is the Shadow. Overall, this board is a pretty flat rocker, nice volume. You're going to see that this model is actually more accepted now, especially when you see Kelly Slater and Dane Reynolds riding these kinds of boards that to most surfers, they kind of go, ugh. But for Southern California, these boards work really, really well because they generate their own speed. And when you start diving into the designs of these boards, you kind of go, oh, okay, I get it. I see how these things work together to make surfboards really, really fun for Southern California and anywhere, really anywhere that has our kind of waves. They're kind of, you know, they don't have a lot of speed. So what I've done with this board, typical fishes have a real straight line for drive. So I added these wings and a fluted, elevated wing. And that, what that does is give nice transition and release, but a wing is a pivot point. And the downside of some of the fishes is when you start to do your cutty, it starts wanting to run towards the flats. It's really hard to hook and rebound off the whitewater. And when you pull in the tail and have a nice round template, it gives a nice smooth turn. And that's what this board does. It has the elements, the drive, the speed, the fun that a fish has, but it allows you to surf more vertically in the pocket without giving up that fish characteristic,
so
which we always...
You can gain that speed, so you can even ride this, you can get tons of waves on a 3-foot day.
Yeah, you can get tons of speed on a 3-foot day, as well as riding it in good waves, right? So it's a really, really fun design. It's the Von Sol Shadow.
Love it. Okay, now tell us a little bit about this style here.
This is a fish, okay? And the fishes of old were really originally knee boards, but these fish are a high performance surfboard. And everything that you find in a fish, which is surface area, is what makes surfing super fun, especially in our kind of waves. So when you start diving into designs of these boards, you're modifying the templates and really the bottom contour and the rail shapes to allow the board to surf more vertically, where most fishes want to go more horizontal.
Right.
So this particular board's made of EPS, which is a really, really, it's a really light surfboard. And it has a nice flex pattern so that when you hit a turn, the thing just wants to be like a rocket ripping out of the turn. So a nice clustered fin configuration, so the board wants to pivot. And then as you start to look at the outline, it pulls into the tail, especially after the wing, the second wing, and it just bangs in so that when you're in the pocket, the board will want to surf up and down. So it's a really, really great design. This is the Von Sol Moonfish, and it's a fantastic
fish design. So it basically
is
like a magic carpet ride. It kind of surfs itself.
Oh yeah, and that's the fun thing about, you know, when you build a quiver, you want to have different designs within your quiver to suit certain kinds of
Absolutely.
Waves or a different state of mind. So fishes are not only a necessary element to your quiver because they generate a lot of speed, but they're a state of mind because they're a really, really fun surfboard. They do the job, especially when it's hard to find speed in a wave.
Exactly. And you've been surfing for decades. So
35
you know,
years, 36
as a
years.
Surfer, what style? And I'm sure when you're shaping these boards, you're thinking about, okay, what kind of wave can I catch?
Yeah, when you design boards, you're really trying to find a new apex to every design. And so just like Scotty Cameron with his putters, you know, you're trying to take a tool and make it better. Okay, and that's what we're doing with these Von Sol fishes, is trying to find a design and make it better.
Right.
So you can surf at a peak performance in this kind of a design.
What a concept, right?
Yeah.
And you have one more shape to show us?
Yeah, I've got another shape to show you.
Okay, this is another shape by Sean Mattison. Tell us a little bit about this design.
This particular design is called the Double Black Diamond. And as you look at different shapes, again, you're going to fall into different categories. The one thing about all the boards that we are designing at Von Sol is boards with a lot of surface area. And surface area generate a lot of speed, and you'll see that all of our boards are quads. And essentially, when you got a really, really wide tail, having the fins on the rail make the board much more maneuverable, whereas if you did it as a tri-fin, it would spread the fins out.
Right.
So they're not working quite as well in harmony as you would if you had the fins close to each other in proximity.
So shaping a board is not only the specs of it, but it also depends on the fins and the fin placement.
Yeah, when you dive into multi-fin surfboards, you'll find that, like a quad, the fin setup relate to the overall design. And you have to design it that way, because in a normal tri-fin, we have a concept of what works and what doesn't, because the fin placement are generally in the same location. When you look at quads, you start going, whoa, fin placements are all over the map. You've got to look at the elements of the fin shape, the fin cluster, where it is in proximity to the outline and the rail. And getting the board to go, okay, what do you want the thing to do? When you have a real high performance board, basically you want the thing to go vertical and still hold power and be really loose. So part of what we're doing, especially for people of our ages, is, you know, you get a surfboard that does a lot of the work for you, just going, yeah. So
if it could do an awful lift for me, I would be stoked.
This is the engine of a board. You know, your bottom contours making Venturi effect, where the really wants to get up and go. So surface area absorbs more energy of the wave.
Right.
Okay. So when you start pulling in the nose of a board, it allows you to surf more vertically, and it allows you to climb the face without being in the way.
Right.
Wider boards generally will want to make you surf more horizontal. Mm-hmm. So this particular board is a very high performance board. You can send this thing straight up, hit the 12 o'clock mark, and send it straight back down.
Nice.
But having speed without putting a lot of effort into it. So this is the Von Sol Double Black Diamond. It's an awesome design.
I like to try all three boards, because I like the surfboards to surf for me. And where can we pick these up?
Surf Ride is going to have these available.
Great. All right. Sean Mattison with Von Sol. Keeping the soul with fishes.